Guys, this is my channel Majestic JV and this is my first video on YouTube. I hope you guys will enjoy it. So in this video I'm filming Lake Wakatipu. So Lake Wakatipu is in Queenstown and it's a south of Newzealand. So Queenstown is one of the most exciting destinations surrounded by these towering mountains. You can see in this video as well, so at the back those big mountains. And Queenstown is a hub of adventure, so whenever you guys come to New Zealand, must visit Queenstown. You will love it. You will love the breathtaking views I'm gonna show you in this video as well. So I'm gonna tell you more about this Lake Wakatipu. So this Lake Wakatipu, it's an inland lake also known as Finger Lake in the South Island of New Zealand. So it is in the southwest corner of Otago region near its boundary with Southland. So this lake is the New Zealand longest lake and New Zealand third largest lake after the Lake Tapu and Lake Tianao at 291 kilometers square. And the surface of the lake sits at 310 meter above sea level, but at its deepest point the lake is 380 meter deep. Wow, it's very deep lake. So you can see the scenic beauty in this video of this lake. You can see that mountain at the back with the snow capped. So that is a remarkable mountain. So its range lies along its southeastern edge. It is a popular venue for adventure tourism with ski fills and paragliding, bungee jumping and tramping tracks within easy reach. So I'm gonna tell you more about this lake. So this Lake Wakatipu is very huge, as I told you before. Therefore, you know, the people who like to swim, they can go for swimming in the lake because it's not salty at all and you can open your eyes under the water and not to worry about swallowing salty water unexpectedly. So it's a great thing for the swimmers. They can. But one more thing, the water temperature at this time in August, it's 8.75 degrees Celsius. I know it's pretty cold, but when it's sunny, so you can swim easily, definitely. And I'm going to tell you more. So in this lake, you can find five types of fish. So the names are rainbow trout, brown trout, chinook, salmon, New Zealand longfin eel and climbing galaxias. So these types of fishes you can see when you swim in this lake. So you will love it, you know. You will love the breathtaking view around this lake. You can see in this video as well. So I'm gonna walk on the lake so you guys can walk with me. So I'm gonna take you on the walk so you can enjoy the whole view of this lake. So let's go, guys. Let's go. everyone, I'm back again with my second destination in Queenstown. Here I'm entering Queenstown Gardens. You can see how beautiful it is with those long trees on the side, and I'm gonna walk you through so you can enjoy the views on the walk. So if you ever come to Queenstown, you can visit these Queenstown Gardens. They are just few minutes walk from central Queenstown. They are very beautiful. These landscape gardens in has plenty of spaces, you know, you can sit and admire the beauty of the gardens. So these gardens has pristine lawns, large water feature, wide variety of trees and plants. So welcome to the Queenstown Gardens. Let's get started. So you're gonna enjoy everything I'm telling you on the way. So let's go on the pathway in the garden. Here you can see the ducks as well. So you're gonna see these ducks everywhere in Queenstown. So this garden has rose garden as well at the end. So everything in combination gives you like perfect escape from downtown Queenstown. And as we all know, gardens are like popular place to take a picnic. You can relax with your friends and families, and you can enjoy the view of Lake Wakatipu, the one I've shown you already in my video, as I've started my video with Lake Wakatipu. So here you can see this large water feature. It's really beautiful. Here we can sit, you can see that sitting area, you can sit here and enjoy this water feature. If not, you can just walk around the garden. There's so many places you can sit on. So the most visible trees in this garden, you're gonna see, are the Douglas fir, which gives you like a protective coverage around the garden, as they're really, really huge with the huge coverage. So the gardens are also a popular place with golf and stuff, as we got golf club here as well at the end. So these frisbees can easily be purchased. You can purchase this stuff from the most outdoor shops in the town center. And if you walk in the garden, and we got other activities as well around the garden, so they're just hidden in the grounds. You will also come across the local bowling club and tennis club. So we got Queenstown Ice Arena as well. It's just right next to the park. So if you really want to do other activities, so you can go for those as well. So here you can see this little bridge in the garden, and you can see this little lake in the garden with the water feature. So you're gonna see everything I've told you in this video, and I hope you're gonna love this destination as well. So let's go and enjoy the views. Hey guys, so finally we are in central of Queenstown after Queenstown Gardens. So now I'm gonna show you this Queenstown Bay in central of Queenstown. As I told you, Queenstown is one of the New Zealand most exciting destinations. So there's lots of scenic beauty you can enjoy. So let's go to Queenstown Bay. It's a Queenstown main beach. Look straight forward towards Cecil and Water Peaks. Perfect for swim on a hot day. One of the reasons you will find Queenstown Bay is a popular for visitors during summer. Here you can hire stuff like paddle boats, kayaks and water boats, so which will add more fun to your activities or adventures. Here you can walk with me on the lake. You can enjoy the scenic beauty of the Queenstown and those big mountains at the back. So let's get close to town where I'm gonna show you more stuff. But before we reach Queenstown, I'm gonna let you guys enjoy this beauty of Queenstown and this lake. So enjoy guys, I'll get back to you again. Okay guys, now this is the time for cruise ride. So as I told you before, the Queenstown is full of adventure, so let's get on this ride together. And you will listen to the instructor as well, as he gonna tell us about the lake and what's around the lake. So let's get to it together. Okay, I hope you will enjoy it. Let's
go. It's a highly unlikely event of some sort of emergency, folks. Your life jacket is from the big viewing slip. And of course you'll have to move the phone. And pretty much, guys, if it's on a slightly cooler day like today, you probably have to pay attention to hear those instructions, because I'll probably try to do it for times of ice cold beer, guys, 3 or 4 different times of wine,
the view from Skyline Gondola. You can take gondola up on Bob's Peak. It's high above Queenstown to the Skyline Complex, from which you can see this whole Queenstown view. So enjoy. So here I'm driving up to Wanaka. So it's an hour drive from Queenstown. It's just outside Mount Aspiring National Park, and there are two routes to get to Wanaka. So the one I'm taking is the fastest way, or it takes just an hour to reach Wanaka. So this route follows Crown Range Road, which turns into Kadrona Valley Road through the Crown Ridge Mountains, and it only takes an hour. But the roads are really steep with many narrow turns, so we should be a little bit careful while driving. And there is also slightly longer route which goes through Cromwell, which adds 30 more minutes to your trip time. But it will avoid the mountains entirely, so we just need to stay on State Highway 6 and follow signs for Wanaka. But the good thing is both routes will give you opportunities to take photos, to sightseeing, and to take some lunch breaks as well. So you will enjoy driving to Wanaka on both routes. So let's drive to Wanaka together so you guys can enjoy those views as well with me. So let's go, guys. Hey guys, I hope you guys enjoyed my video. Please don't forget to like, subscribe and share so you will get the notification when I will upload my next video. Thank you so much. See you guys.